Let's imagine that it's 1867, the year Canada became a country, and an era when your average Canadian family spent an exorbitant amount of time and physical energy cutting down trees so that they would have enough wood to heat their homes in the winter. Remember, in those days, most of us lived on farms or in small villages, and most of us had access to wood as an abundant fuel source. The price of wood was often as little as the price of an axe and the willingness to go out into the woods to cut down a tree. These days, if you actually own a home with a fireplace, it's most likely a fake. Our national heating narrative is no longer about wood, but about being fully wired in. It's a consumer revolution that Ecobee, a Canadian smart thermostat maker, kicked off about a decade ago. And it's a fight they continue to wage amid stiff competition from American giants with deep pockets and all the genius that Silicon Valley can provide.
I told people in 1994, like, if you're not on the internet, you know, your spouse will leave you, your kids will hate you, and your dog won't walk with you. And I feel the same way about machine learning and AI.
Stuart Lombard, founder and CEO of Ecobee, says that we're living in a golden age of entrepreneurship. 10 years ago, he had an idea for a smart thermostat, a gadget far superior to the cheap units then available. It was a great idea. The hard part was convincing investors to believe in it.
I tell people I remember standing outside of First Canadian Place and had been rejected for about the 172nd time. And they told me, fail fast, Stuart, life is too short, go do something else with your life. And I came down out of First Canadian Place and I was standing on the street corner, and I don't smoke, but I was so stressed that I pummed a smoke off the guy next to me. And I'm standing there on the corner and I'm smoking, don't tell my wife that. And I'm like, should I quit? And I was like, you know what? The day that, you know, they take the keys out of my cold dead hand, that's the day that I'm gonna quit.
After being turned away 172 times, door number 173 finally opened. He got the startup capital he needed. Ecobee has since shipped millions of units and has over 400 employees. It was the first smart thermostat on the scene. Of course, Google's Nest followed, and competition's been fierce.
You know, when we started, we were the first Wi-Fi connected thermostat. We invented the category. People were giving us high fives. We were giving ourselves high fives. We thought we were totally awesome. And we were good. But then Nest came out. And it was like, oh my God, right? And, we were the twin that was, you know, not as funny, not as smart, not as good looking.
Lombard's backers, including Amazon, have expressed their faith in Ecobee to the tune of almost $200 million in startup funding. But to understand just how we got here in home heating, it's important to look back, way back to 1867, and some of the innovations since.
The first wood heating in Canada was in an open hearth, and that was tremendously wasteful of wood. There's about a 10% efficiency rate of burning wood in an open fireplace, but that's what people had, the big, you know, huge open hearth. And they used that for cooking and for heating. By 1867, there were already quite a few Canadians who had the cast iron, what were called coal and wood stoves.
The first major revolution in home heating was a switch from open hearths to cast iron stoves. Canadians still needed wood, though, and lots of it.
So in the winter, what the men and boys did in a family, and often neighbors would all do this together, because transportation is so much easier in the winter in Canada, again, because of the ice. So they would get their horses and wagons and go and cut the amount of wood that they anticipated that they would need for the next winter. So about a hectare per family, per farm.
To give you an idea of the scale, let's take the city of Kingston, Ontario, which has about 52,000 private dwellings and covers 75 square kilometers. Locals would need to cut down 520 square kilometers of forest every year. By the late 1940s, thermostat-controlled furnaces eased homeowners' addiction to wood, replacing it with fossil fuels.
while people had wood stoves and wood furnaces, it was really impossible for anybody to leave the house for any amount of time, especially not in the dead of winter. So, but with the oil furnace for heating, what was so amazing about it is that it could be completely automated. You could have a thermostat that would allow the oil into the stove in an amount where it wouldn't explode or catch fire, or and you didn't have to do anything at all. It would look after itself. What it did, what the automated furnace did, was it actually allowed people, and by people in this case, I'm really thinking of women, whose job it was, you know, the expression to keep the home fires burning. It was their job with their physical labor and tending and care to make sure that the fires never went out. And once automation came, there were all kinds of possibilities that came up for women.
Historians say no energy transition has ever been accepted until it was cheaper and more convenient. And that's Ecobee's value proposition. Yes, we still consume great gobs of fossil fuels heating our homes, but Ecobee's at the forefront of changing things. So, how did it all start?
It came to be because in 2007, I was thinking about how I could reduce my environmental footprint. And one of the insights that we had was that heating and cooling is 40 to 70% of your home's energy use. And so actually better managing your heating and cooling is the best thing you can do. It's cheap, it's inexpensive, anybody can do it. And so I decided to program my thermostat.
Now I can control the temperature of my home from anywhere with my phone.
Now, remember, this was 2007. Smart thermostats hadn't been invented yet. Barack Obama had just declared he was going to run for the presidency. Steve Jobs debuted the original iPhone. And Britney Spears had shaved her head.
You know, if we could create a product that was connected on your phone so you could always come home to a comfortable house, that used internet and internet data, things like weather, to make smarter decisions for you, how much better could we do? And the really cool part is that we estimate our customers have saved enough energy to take the city of Miami off the grid, and so it's a massive impact.
But can a Canadian company compete with the titans, like Nest Labs, owned by Google's corporate parent, Alphabet, and Honeywell, which has a market cap of $100 billion? To take on the giants, will Ecobee have to move to California?
I hope not. I don't think so. I think there are lots of reasons, as I said, that it's great to build a company here. I mean, clearly you have to go where your customers are. And so, you know, we need to be, you know, constantly in touch with our customers. But you also have the opportunity to stand back a little bit out of the fray. There's so much frenetic activity in Silicon Valley that it really gives you a chance, I think, to be a lot more thoughtful. And frankly, build a better business because you're not constantly trying to keep up with the Joneses or, you know, attack that latest trend. It really gives you a chance to just be more thoughtful.
Lombard is an idealist. He's not just selling a thermostat, but a research tool, and perhaps a means to help make the world a better place.
But now we have thermostats in millions and millions of homes. And so we have this program called Donate Your Data, where as a consumer, you can say, I'm going to donate my data. And we take that data and we anonymize it and we put it into these very large data sets. And then we share those with scientists and researchers who are working on all kinds of interesting problems, which range from like, how do we make homes more energy efficient, to how can we help seniors live longer in their homes. And the results are truly outstanding, and it's all about how do we create this future tomorrow that is way better than today.
We live in a funny time. A time when axes are no longer seen as vital household tools, but as toys for hipsters looking to go out to their local axe throwing lounge on a Friday night. It's a society where much less rural, overwhelmingly urban, and more aware than ever that what we do today in terms of our energy consumption is going to matter tomorrow. And I'm getting cold. It's freezing out here. Alexa, I need the heat set to 21 degrees in the kitchen and in the living room. I'm coming home.